So finally, some positive news for the students who are stuck overseas. Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison has said that the widespread immunization against the coronavirus could lead to the opening of Australia's international borders. So in this video, we are going to give you a quick update on that. Now, if you haven't done it already, I highly recommend you to go and download Overseas Students Guide 2021. We just launched this guide last week and we have updated this guide with lots of information and content in relation to COVID-19 and other useful content for the students who are planning to study in Australia or currently studying in Australia. It is available for free to download from our website and the link is in the description below. So after watching this video, I highly recommend you to go and download that guide. And if you have already downloaded the guide, thank you very much. I will look forward to your feedback in the comment section below. Now coming back to the video topic. So Australia started its biggest immunization program in the history of the country from 22nd of February 2021. The rollout of the vaccine was supposed to start at the end of March, but it's rolling out 1 month earlier than planned. And the rollout of this vaccine has brought lots of hope within Australia and overseas. The Australian Prime Minister was one of the first ones to receive this vaccine. And this was done in order to boost the community confidence to take up this vaccine. Obviously, some people are questioning the safety of the vaccine. So in order to get the community confidence, the Australian Prime Minister was one of the first ones to receive the jab. Now, Australia's vaccine rollout plan is divided into three main phases. In the first phase, which is named as 1A and 1B, you will see majority of the health line workers, quarantine workers, aged care workers, and elderly adults getting the jab. So people who are either working in the front lines or are vulnerable to the COVID-19 will receive the vaccine first. Then in the second phase, which is named as 2A and 2B, you will see majority of adults getting the jab. That's when majority of Australians will be able to get the vaccine for this virus. Now in the last phase, phase 3, if recommended, under 18 kids will be given a vaccine as well. It is not confirmed that they will receive the vaccine, but if it's recommended, they'll probably get in the phase 3. And as we discussed earlier, international students who are already in Australia will receive this vaccine for free as well. And the aim is to get the whole population of Australia vaccinated by October 2021. So that was in regards to the vaccine. As I said, it has brought lots of hope and optimism in the market. Now, when Australian Prime Minister was asked about the Australia's international border, he said it's very possible that COVID-19 vaccine may reopen Australia's international borders. And he further added, "What I have always been confident about is taking one step at a time when it comes to managing the virus. I am confident that as we move through the vaccination process, we can significantly change how things are done here in Australia." And he further added to that, "It is quite reasonable expectations that as the time goes on and the vaccine roll out across the world and here in Australia, you should rightly expect that things will change how we manage the virus." So that is definitely a positive lookout since the start of this COVID-19 vaccine rollout. As we already know that there is no specific timeline given in regards to the borders reopening, but now there is a hope and light at the end of this tunnel. Now the key things that might impact the opening of Australia's international borders, that include things like how successful is the vaccine rollout in Australia and other parts of the world. Most likely, foreign national might be required to have a vaccination for COVID-19 before entering into Australia. And foreign nationals who are coming to Australia might also still need to do quarantine in hotels as well. But we'll get a clearer picture of what it might look like when foreign nationals are allowed to come into Australia, hopefully in the near future. And as soon as we hear further updates regarding international border or any other news that are relevant for international students, we'll keep you posted on this channel. So make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you do find the value in the video, please make sure to share it with your friends and network as well. And if you do find the value in the video, please make sure to share it with your friends and network as well. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.